Hello, welcome to Spine Educational Channel. I'm re-uploading one of my old videos due to the copyright issues. And if you have seen it, just skip it and expect fresh new ones soon. This one will cover VFX in Spine. Right now we are looking at my previous works, where you can see how VFX can enrich your works. Okay, now let's get to the video.
Here we have sequences. And what I do mostly, I make them flow in perspective over some surfaces. Let's see this example. I have a tutorial done. I'm using linked mesh and exactly the same sequence. Just with linked mesh, I deform one mesh and the other meshes just copy transforms. So here are the meshes. This one. I have deformed it in setup pose. You can also bind the mesh to the bones and modify the bone position. This one and this one. Okay, let's see the next example. Here's another use case of the same technique. I have linked mesh and I have other frames copying transforms using linked mesh functionality. And this time I bounded the mesh to the bones, so I can move the bones instead. Here, let's play. These are two VFX that I use, and let's see how you can combine them and actually use them in some animation. You can use those and attach those bones to the hands or antennas. And let me show you in preview window. Let me hide myself. Okay, here is it. And let's actually hide this panel. So this is the animation. And you can attach these bones, these ones, to hands or antennas or wherever you want, somewhere dynamically moving. And this way you can just move them and rotate them. They would keep the animation. This is very useful, and you avoid a lot of headaches with this setup. Just two sequences, three instances, and two instances of this. Okay, let's see next example. Believe me or not, but we are using same technique, just in a different use case. Okay, this is the clean VFX sequence. And this is the final animation. It looks like tornado effect. I have covered this in different tutorial. I will post the link on the screen. And you can see that the mesh also is bound to these bones. So you can move them while in animation. I haven't moved them here. And the top part is using basic scaling of the parent. And the rotation happens in the children local space. You can check them in tutorial. Also, the effects are offsetted a little bit, and they even have color different a little bit with a gradually reducing alpha. Okay, let's see the next example. Some groundbreaking hit. The bones, and let's play them slowly. Okay, let's see now what we have. We have this effect, 4 frames, and we have the same effect copied but different color. You can see it has also a little bit offset in the timing. Here, 1 frame, and it gives some kind of depth in 3D space. Also, it gets scaled and moved along the animation. Here is it. Okay, let's see the next example. Okay, another breaking animation, ground, hit, impact, explosion, I don't know how to call. But same techniques, same effect. Just here, you can see that with 2 images, you can achieve some kind of debris effect, like no need to do different like bones and animate them as I did in previous example. Let's see the previous one. You can see that here we have this part separated. Although I have it in one image. Here. But I used bones to animate them separately. While the other one, they are just images that I combined and creating illusion of multiple rocks. Okay, let's see next example. By the way, where I am, let's enable the camera. Okay, let's see the other. Here we have lightning. We have a bolt, this one that I made myself. I drew it, you can see from messy lines here. Don't be afraid drawing yourself if you don't have drawing skills. I don't have either, I have some basic skills. So the main bolt is combined with the like secondary effect to give more power. And we have impact here. These are combined. And this impact, I'm very sure that this impact I also will be using in other animation. Also this bolt separately. Otherwise I would combine the bolt with this secondary animation in Photoshop or After Effects. So this is what I was saying before. If you are going to use separately in different animation, then leave them as it is. But if they are only in this animation, better to combine them in one sequence. Okay, let's see. I think next one is also lightning. Yes, again, lightning, different style. But the same thing. Again, I have impact. I have also, you can see that this is the same impact as I had previously. So I reuse some VFX along other projects in the same like domain of the project. And this is another effect. And this is the bolt. By the way, if you want to copy past the bolt, you can just find the root bone that contains all the effects, and I suggest having one. Don't create a mess in the project. And when you copy, it copies also the keys, and this way you have two overlapping effects. You can move them and you have simultaneously playing bolts. And if you want to offset one, you could go and find them here, but sometimes you have a very big hierarchy duplicated. So this time I will just right click on the original one to hide it and select all the frames for the second one. I am very sure that this is showing only the new copied bolt and would offset it. Later I would hit locate the playhead here, key all the visible keys and copy past at the zero frame. Okay, maybe I would also hide this because the original one starts exactly already with one bolt. Okay, let's show it back. And we have two bolts exactly looking the same but with a delay. So this way you can copy several bolts. Okay, let's see next example. The last two examples are about teleporting characters, teleport effect. Let's see it. It hides and shows. It hides and shows. It may be a little bit confusing, but when the character is here, always very clean. So this yellow triangle is actually the silhouette of the character. I can reuse the like create in Photoshop the silhouette quickly, just reducing the size and adding some blurry effect. And again, you can see that I have one effect, just duplicated it and with a little rotation. I have three instances of the same effect appearing one after another, and they have also color different. And this is a separate animation effect. Okay, what was it? Let's see the other one. I don't want to save this. Okay, this one is actually moving. It's not teleporting, rather than moving magically, like dashing crayon. Again, I use the same technique here. We can see we have one effect, just duplicated four times, and with a little bit delay and color adjustment, we have main that has white bright color, and the other one that are more looking secondary, just to give a rich view of the VFX. But basically that's it. We can see also that this VFX also gets scaled. Don't forget to use every tool here available to avoid more frames in the final spreadsheet. Okay, let's see now how you could get some VFX if you are not like artist and you are not provided with some VFX from the developers. What to do in that case? We have two popular libraries here. The first one is my favorite one, and they both are made primarily for After Effects. But we can use on also spine characters or environment, whatever. So they provide movie files. They provide, this one provides PNG sequences with alpha channel. And you can use them in your YouTube channel, in TV series, in games, wherever you want. You can even sell the content that you created with this VFX, like characters or environment, whatever. But there are some exceptions, like you can't give ability to users to modify effects or resell the product. Make sure you read the license. Don't take my word. Just so it comes with assets that you already can use, or you can go in After Effects. If you have experience in After Effects, you can combine those effects directly in After Effects and export them as PNG sequences and use them in Spine. Both libraries provide some responsive galleries where you can search by name or navigate to look and find exactly what you want to use in your Spine, or even you want to combine this, this and this, you go and find in After Effects and combine both, all of them, and export new PNG sequence. Also, sometimes you can see, oh, I like this effect, how it would look like reverse. You can save the GIF right from here. And in this tool, as GIF.com, you can upload it here and use this functionality to reverse, and you will see how it would look reversed. So maybe you want to see any other opportunity from that GIF. Okay, that was it. And before going quickly, I would like to show how it looks in After Effects. If you want to combine the effects directly here and maybe modify the color, they are fully modifiable. You can come here, and here are the, I have two tabs for both libraries. Here. And you can just drag and drop. For example, let's find some cool effects and drag and drop it here and try to combine. If you are familiar with After Effects, you would quickly understand what's going here. Here are they. And basically you can combine them here. Okay, that was it now.